Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture of finite element analysis. In today's class, we are going to solve problems on plane strain. So I'll read out the question for you. For the plane strain element shown in the figure, the nodal displacements are u1 is equals to 0.005 mm, v1 is equals to 0.002 mm, u2 is equals to 0.0 mm, v2 is equals to 0.0 mm, u3 is equals to 0.005 mm, v3 is equals to 0.0 mm. Find the element strain and stresses. Take E, which is called as Young's modulus, is equals to 70 GPa, and mu, which is called as Poisson's ratio, is equals to 0.3, and unit thickness. Unit means we have to take thickness is equals to 1. So this diagram has been given in the question. So the three coordinates are one. First coordinate is 5 comma 15. The second coordinate is 15 comma 5, and the third coordinate is 25 comma 15. So we have to find out the element strain and stresses from this. So we were taking these nodal displacements as u1, u2, u3, u4, u5 and u6. But in this question, the nodal displacements has been given as u1, v1, u2, v2 and u3, v3. Okay, so we will follow our notation because there are many reference test books. So we are following Ramamurthy as our reference test books. So in Ramamurthy, we have the nodal displacements as u1, u2, u3, u4, u5, u6. Okay, so for us, v1 is u2. So for us, u1, u2, u3, u4, u5, u6 values has been given. Okay, so it does not change the concept. The concept remains the same. You can use any of these notations, whatever the test book you are referring, you can use any of those notations. Okay, no need to think about that. So these nodal displacements has been given in the question for us. So u1 for us is 0.005 mm, but we are not denoting by v1, so we are using u2. So v1 is u2 for us, so 0.002 mm. u3, the next value is u3. So u1, u2, u3, u4, u5, u6 values has been given for us. So I am writing those values here. So 0.0 mm, next to 0.0 mm, 0.005 mm and 0.0. Because in some test books, they take nodal displacements as, like we take nodal displacements as u1, u2. But they take u1 and v1. For node 1, it is also, we can also take in that way. So u1, u2, we take in this way. In some of the textbooks, it is given as u1, v1. So that's why u1, v1, this data has been given in that form. Okay, so we are using our one form which we have been following since the starting. So u1, u2, u3, u4 and u5. u6. So at every node we are going to take two displacements. One is horizontal displacement and one is vertical displacement. So these displacement values has been given in the question. Okay, so we have to find out the element strain and stresses and take E is equals to 60 GPa. So whenever GPa is given, so this is the given data. So when GPa is given, we multiply it with 10^3 so that we get Newton per mm square, because everything is in terms of mm. So Poisson's modulus of elasticity should also be in terms of mm. And unit thickness, so thickness we denote it by delta. So delta is given as unit. Unit means 1, so 1 mm is our thickness. And all the coordinates are also in terms of mm. So what are our coordinates? The first coordinate is x1, y1. Second coordinate is x2, y2. And the third coordinate is x3, y3. So this thing is given in the question, which is called as plane strain. So for plane strain, the only thing which changes is the matrix D. So for plane strain, the only formula which changes is the matrix D. This matrix is called as material matrix. So what is the formula for plane strain? Formula of D for plane strain. Okay, there is a formula of D for plane stress and there is a formula of D for plane strain. Okay, so in this question, plane strain has been given. We have to take the formula of D for plane strain. So the formula is E by 1 plus mu into 1 minus 2 mu, 1 minus mu, 1 minus mu, 1 minus 2 mu by 2, mu, mu, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay? So we are going to find out first the matrix D. So D is equals to E by 1 plus mu. So mu value has, E value is also given in the question. So E is 70 into 10 power 3 by 1 plus mu is given in the question. So mu is called as Poisson's ratio, which is given as 0.3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.3, 1 minus 2 mu, 1 minus mu. So 1 minus 0.3, 1 minus 0.3, and 1 minus 2 into 0.3 by 2. Mu is 0.3, mu is 0.3, and rest all values are zeros. So we got this material matrix D. So we can find out this value in the calculator. And this matrix D is coming out to be 70 into 10 power 3 divided by 1 plus 0.3 into 1 minus 2 into 0.3. Okay, this is 134615. This value is 134615.384. This value from the calculator I got, and this 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. This is 0.3, 0, 0.3. 1 minus 0.3 is 0.7. This is 0, 0, 0. And this value we can find out from the calculator. 1 minus 2 into 0.3 divided by 2. So this is 0.2. So we got the matrix D. Okay. So now we can find out, okay, U is given, the matrix U is given in the question. So what is U? Matrix U is U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6. Had it been 6 displacements, we would have got up to 8. Had it been 10 displacements, we would have got up to 10. So here we have only 6 displacements, so it is up to 6. So these values has been given in the question. So these values I am substituting. So that is 0.005, 0.002, U3 is 0, okay, 0.0 is 0. So U4 is again 0, U5 is 0.005, U6 is 0. See, there are many ways in which nodal displacements can be given. Sometimes in the question, he will also give you the nodal displacements in this form. The nodal displacements are 0.005, 1, 2, 3, 7, 2, 1, which means this is U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6, U7 values, transpose. So they can give in the matrix form as well. You should be able to interpret all these types of given data. Okay. So nodal displacements means those are our U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6. Corresponding values of U. So we have the U matrix which has been given in the question in this form. Next, in order to find out element strain, so element strain formula is, strain is denoted by E, so which is B into U. Because B is called as strain displacement matrix. Strain displacement means strain per unit displacement. So that is strain by displacement. So if you multiply strain by displacement into displacement, what you will get? So strain by displacement into, if you multiply the displacement matrix, so displacement and displacement gets cancelled, we are going to get the strain values. So from this, The state can be obtained, which is denoted by E. So E is equals to B into U. So in order to find out the strain, we will have to find out the matrix D. We already have this U matrix which has been given in the question, but in order to find out strain, we will have to find out the matrix D. So I am going to find out the matrix D. So the formula of matrix B is same for both plane strain and plane stress conditions. So B is called as strain displacement matrix. Which is denoted by B. So the formula is 1 by 2A, B10, B20, B30, 0C1. 0C2 0C3 C1 B1 C2 B2 C3 B3. So we have to find out these values. A is area, so we know that the area of triangle can be calculated from this formula, 1 by 2 into 1 1 1 x1 y1 x2 y2 x3 y3. So 1 by 2 is determinant of this thing. Okay, so x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3 values has been given in the question. Is equals to 1 by 2 into 1, 1, 1, x1, y1. So this is my x1, y1. 5, 15. X2, y2. So this is my x2 and this is y2. 15, 5. x3, y3. So this is my x3 and this is y3, which is 25 and 15. So we can calculate determinant. So 1 by 2 into, how to calculate determinant? This is plus 1 into AD minus BC. So this is 15 into 15 minus 25 into 5 minus 5 into AD minus BC. So 15 minus 5. And plus 15 into AD minus BC, so 25 minus 15. So you can calculate this value in the calculator. So this is coming out to be 1 by 2 into, this value is 200. So 1 by 2 into 200 is 100. So area is 100 mm square. So we got area here. Now we have to calculate D1 and C1 values. So we know that the formula of B1 is Y minus Y, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, B2 Y minus Y, B3 Y minus Y, X minus X, X minus X, X minus X. So when you have B1, put 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. For this one, C1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. So you can substitute this Y2, Y3 values which is given in the diagram. So this is X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3. Okay. So this is my X1, Y1, this is X2, Y2, and this is X3, Y3. So Y2 minus Y3. So Y2 is 5, Y3 is 15, so this is minus 10. Next, B2 is Y3 minus Y1, so Y3 is 15 and Y1 is 15, that is 0. And this is Y1 minus Y2, so Y1 is 15 and Y2 is 5. So this is 10. X3 minus X2. So X3 is 25. X2 is 15. So this is 10. X1 minus X3. x1 is 5 and x3 is 25. So this is minus 20. X2 minus x1, 15 minus 5, that is 10. So I can get this matrix B here. So I can obtain the matrix B 1 by 2 into A. A we got as 100. So 1 by 2 into 100. B1 0. So that is minus 10. 0. B2 0. So B2 is 0. B2 0. B3 0. So B3 is 10. 0. B3 is 10. 0. 0 C1. So C1 is 10. So 0, 10. 0 C2. So C2 is minus 20. So 0, minus 20. C3 is 10. So we are going to substitute that 10 here. 0, 10. So 10 minus 10 minus 20 is 0, 10, 10. Let me just quickly verify it. 10 minus 10 minus 20 is 0, 10, 10. Yes. So we got the matrix B as well. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to find out the strain. So strain is, like I said, B into U. So this is strain. We have to find out strain. Strain E. And the question is asking us to find out strain, element strain. So B into U. So we got the matrix B, that is 1 by 2 into 100, 1 by 200, minus 10, 0, 0, 0, 10, 0, 0, 10, 0, minus 20, 0, 10, 10, minus 10, minus 20, 0, 10, 10. Into U. We got the matrix U. Matrix U has been given in the question, that is U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6. So 0.005, 0.005, 0.002, and this is 0.0, and again 0, next to 0.005, and last one is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the matrix U. So if we multiply these two matrices, what is the order of this matrix? 3 rows and 6 columns. So this matrix has got 3 rows and 6 columns. And this matrix has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rows and 1 column. So in order to multiply any two matrices, the second, the columns, the number of columns of this matrix should be equal to the number of rows of this matrix. So 6 and 6, it is matching. So we can multiply this and the final output will be 3 and 1. So it will have 3 rows and 1 column. Okay. So this matrix will have 3 rows, 1, 2, 3 and 1 column. So we can multiply this and this. So after multiplying those two values, I am getting 1 by 200. So first row into first column. So first row is minus 10, minus 10 into 0.005, and that is minus 0.05, and 10 plus 10 into 0.005. The first value is 0 here. Again, second row, first column. So this corresponding element will multiply with this. 10 into 0.002 minus 20 into 0 plus 10 into 0. Okay. So this is coming out to be 0.02, and the last one 10 into 0.005
minus 10 into 0.002. This one is coming out to be 0.08. So 1 by 200 into this value. So 1 by 200 into 0 is 0. 1 by 200 into 10 power minus 4. And for this one, four into 10 power minus 4. So we can take 10 power minus 4 common. So this will come 0, 1, 4. Okay, so these are the element strains. So we have to find out the stresses also. The formula of stress is, stress is denoted by sigma, and the formula is D into B into U. B into U we already got, which is called as strain, and this is the value. So this B into U is called as strain, which we already got. And we are going to directly substitute this one, and D also we already obtained the value of D. So I'm going to write down the value which we got. So the matrix D is seven into 10 power 5 divided by 52. 7337002000. Yeah, whatever the value of D we got, that is similar to this value. Just take these terms outside and multiply it, you will get the final value as same. So this value is the same value which we got. So this is my matrix D which we got. And similarly, E is 10 power minus 4 into 0, 1, 4. So if we see this, the number of this is a 3 by 3 matrix and this is a 3 by 1 matrix. So the final order will be 3 by 1. So it will have 3 rows and 1 column. So we are going to multiply this. So these outer values we are going to multiply here. 7 into 10 power 5 into 10 power minus 4 by 52. And the matrices we are going to get the final answer as 3 rows and 1 column. So this is 7 into 0, 0, 3 into 1, 3. So this will be 3. 0 into 4 will become 0. So 3 into 0 plus 7 into 1, 7 plus 0 into 4. So this is 7. 0 into 0, 0, 0 into 1, 0, 2 into 4, 8. So this is going to be 8. So now we got these values. So we can find out this value in the calculator. This value. Seven into 10 power 5 into 10 power minus 4 divided by 52. And this is 1.346. So this value is 1.346. So 1.346 into 3. Next to 1.346 into 7 is 9.422, and 1.346 into 8. 1.346 into 8. This is 10.76. So this is called as stresses. And in this stress, this value is called as sigma x. sigma x is 4.038 newton per mm square, and this is called as sigma y, that is 9.422 newton per mm square, and this is tau xy, shear stress, that is 10.76 newton per mm square.
Okay. So that's it for today. If you have any doubts, you can reach out to me. Thank you. Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture of finite element analysis. In the last class we have solved problems on plane stress and plane strain. In this class we will be solving problems on axis symmetric problems. So in axis symmetric problems, the formulas are similar to the formulas which we studied in the plane stress and plane strain problems. So axis symmetric analysis is that type of analysis in which we have models where a model can be formed by rotating about any axis. For instance, you have a cone. So in order to form a cone, what I can do is I can create a triangle, and if I rotate this triangle about this axis, a cone will be formed. So this cone is symmetrical about y-axis. So this is one of the axis symmetric type of analysis. So I want to be analyzing the complete cone. So what I will be doing is I will be only analyzing a triangular element. So I will be analyzing a triangular element because the basic idea of finite element analysis is to analyze only the important elements of any model. So the critical elements of any model, which will lead to some failure. So if we analyze a triangle, depending on the types of forces and everything, where we can assume how the behavior of cone will be. So these type of analysis, so in axis symmetric problems also, we are going to have triangular elements. So in triangular elements, especially for axis symmetric problems, the two coordinates which will be given is, one is the radius of this, because for this cone we'll be having radius. So one will be the radius and one will be the height. So r comma z will be the type of coordinates we'll be having. So in cones we'll be given a triangular element in which the coordinates will be given in the form of r and z. So the first coordinate will be r1 z1, second coordinate is r2 z2, and the third coordinate is r3 z3. So similarly, we had for formulas of stiffness matrices. So for axis symmetric problems, the stiffness matrix formula is k 2 pi ra into b transpose dv. So the only difference is, in plane stress problems we had delta a, but here we have 2 pi r in place of this. Formulas are quite similar to the formulas which we have studied in plane stress and plane strain problems. Okay, so from this we have to find out r is r1 plus r2 plus r3 by 3, and these r1, r2, r3 values will be given in the question. Area can be calculated from this formula, 1 by 2 into determinant of 1 r1 z1, 1 r2 z2 and 1 r3 z3. So you can find out determinant, and 1 by 2 into this we will be getting the area. Material matrix D, the formula is same. There is only one extra row. If you add one extra row to the formulas of plane stress and plane strain, we will get this material matrix D. Similarly, strain displacement matrix B, which we have to substitute here, can be calculated by using this formula. If you see, this formula is also same to the formulas which we have studied in plane stress and plane strain. There is only one extra row here, the second row. Add this one extra row and it will become the formula for axis symmetric type of problems. So from this you have to calculate b1, b2, b3. So while there we had y coordinates here. So just replace y with z, because we have z here. We used to have x comma y in plane stress and plane strain. So in place of y, just put z here. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. Just put r here. 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2. A1. Rz minus Rz, 2, 3, 3, 2. 2, if 2 is there, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2. If 3 is there, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1. And Z can be found out from this formula, Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by plus Z3 by 3. And you have B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, A1 into A3, and Z values. If you substitute all these values, you will get the strain displacement matrix. Okay, so while we start solving the problems, you will be able to understand how we are going to use this. So we have got all these values. If you substitute these values here, we are going to get the matrix K, and there is only one type of force which is possible. This formula is same as the formula which we have studied in the plane stress, delta L by 2, px1, py1, px2, py2, px3, py3. And after getting the K and F, we are going to substitute in the finite element equation, K into U is equals to F. So we will be getting the nodal displacements U. So after getting K and F, if we substitute K and F, we are going to get U. Similarly, we have the formula for strain. Strain is B into U. So B we will get from this and U. Okay, for B, just a moment. Yeah, for B we have 1 by 2A here, which is multiplied. Okay. So B into U, and for stress we have D into E. So D as it is, and matrix E is B into U. So in place of E, we can substitute B into U. So this is stress formula. So if you remember these 7 formulas, you will be able to solve any type of problem which can be asked from axisymmetric. And axisymmetric problems are very important as far as your final exam is concerned. Okay. So I am going to take the first question. The nodal coordinates for an axisymmetric triangular element are shown in the figure R. Okay, so I am directly writing down the given data. The nodal coordinates are given. R1 is equals to 20, Z1 is equals to 10, R2 is equals to 40 mm, Z2 is equals to 10 mm. R3 is equals to 30 mm and Z3 is equals to 50 mm. So this diagram has been given in the question. This is node 1, node 2, 40 comma 10, and node 3, 30 comma 50. Determine the strain displacement matrix. You have to find only B, matrix B. Okay? So sometimes this will not be given, only diagram will be given. So this is R1, Z1, R2, Z2, R3, Z3. So we have to find out the matrix B. What is the formula for matrix B? This is an axisymmetric problem. It has been clearly mentioned in the question. So the formula of matrix B for axisymmetric problem is B is equals to 1 by 2A, B1 0, B2 0, B3 0. A1 plus B1R plus C1Z by R 0, A2 plus B2R plus C2Z by R 0, A3 plus B3R plus C3Z by R 0, C1 0, C2 0, C3 0. 0 C1, 0 C2, 0 C3. C1, B1, C2, B2, C3, B3. In the test book, in place of B1, beta 1 is given. In place of C1, gamma 1 is given, in place of a1 alpha 1 is given. Notation can be followed, of any textbook notation can be followed. This notation is from Ramamurthy's textbook. I have give you the reference to be Jalaluddin. So don't get confused. We can make use of either b1 or beta 1 here. So we can use any of these notations. So b1 formula is b1. We have to first find out these values a1, b1, c1. So we are going to find out a1, b1, b2, b3. We are going to find out c1, c2, c3. We are going to find out a1, a2, a3. Okay, so what is b? B is z minus z, z minus z, z minus z. So 1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 1. 3, 1, 2. Z2 minus z3. So 10 minus 50 minus 40. Z3 minus z1. 50 minus 10. 50 minus 10 is 40. And z1 minus z2. 10 minus 50 minus 40. Sorry, 10 minus 10, 0. Okay? Z2 minus Z3, Z3 minus Z1, and Z1 minus Z2. C1, C, what is the formula of C1? C1 is R minus R, R minus R, R minus R. 1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 1. 3, 1, 2. R2 minus R3. 40 minus 30, 10. 40 minus 30. R1 minus R3. R1 minus R3. 20 minus 30. Minus 10. R2 minus R1. 40 minus 20. 20. What is the formula of A1, A2, A3? Rz minus Rz. Rz minus Rz. Rz minus Rz. 1, 2, 3, 3, 2. 2, 3, 1, 1, 3. 3, 1, 2, 2, 1. R2, Z3. R2, Z3. So 40, 50. 40 into 50 minus R3, Z2. R3, Z2 is 30 into Z2 is 10. So you can find out this. You can use calculator. And this one is coming out to be 1700. 40 to 50 minus 30 to 10. Yes. R3 Z1. So R3 is 30. Z1 is 10. Yes. R1 Z3 minus R1 Z3. So R1 is 20 and Z3 is 50. So you can find out this by using calculator, and this is coming out to be minus 700. And the last one, R1 Z2. R1 is 20, Z2 is 10, R2 Z1. R2 is 40. And Z1 is 10. And this, you can do this part in the calculator, it's coming out to be minus 200. You got these values, and what is the value of Z and R here? R is R1 plus R2 plus R3 by 3. So R1, R2, R3 values are given in the question. So that is 20 plus 40 plus 30 by 3. 40 plus 30 is 70. 80, 90, 90 by 3 is 30. And you can also find out Z. Z is Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 by 3. So 10 plus 10 plus 50 by 3. So this is what? 70 by 3. So 70 by 3 is how much? 23.3. So 23.3 mm. So we can substitute in the matrix B now. So you will get the matrix B. So matrix B is equals to 1 by 2 into A. Did you find out A? No. What is the formula of A?
1 by 2 into determinant of 1, 1, 1, R1, Z1, R2, Z2, R3, Z3. So 1 by 2 into 1, 1, 1, R1, Z1 is 20, 10, R2, Z2 is 40, 10, and 30, 50. You can find out this determinant. So 1 by 2 into that determinant value is coming out to be, I hope you all can find out this, you know determinant, you know mathematics. So that's coming out to be 400 mm square. So this is 400 mm square. So we got area as well. Now we can substitute in the matrix B. So 1 by 2 into area. So area is 400. Let me just check it. Yes. So 1 by 2 into 400. B1. So B1 is minus 40. 0. B2. B2 is 40. 0. B3. B3 is 0. Again 0. A1. A1 is 1700 plus B1R. B1 is minus 40 plus into minus minus 40 into R. R is 30 plus C1Z. So C1 is 10 plus 10 into Z. Z is 23.3 by R. R is 30. Okay, I'll just rewrite it so that we have enough space to write everything. 0, 0. Okay. V2 was minus 40. 0, B3. Similarly, A2 plus B2R plus C2Z. So A2 is how much? You got the value of A2? Yes, minus 700. So minus 700 plus B2R. So B2 is plus 40 into R. R is 30 plus C2Z. C2 is 20. So plus 20 into Z. Z is 23.3 divided by R. So R is how much? R is 30. So this is 0. Again A3 plus B3R plus C3Z. You have to do. So A3 is how much? A3. A3 is minus 200 plus B3R. So B3 is 0. So 0 into R is 23.3 and C3Z. So C3 is 20. So plus 20 into Z. Z is 23.3. So R is 30 here by R. And this is 0. 0 C1, 0 C1, C1 is 10, 0 C2, C2 is minus 10, and 0 C3, C3 is 20, so 0, 20. Here we have C1, B1, C2, B2, C3, B3. So C1, C2, C1, B1. C2, B2, C3, B2. Okay. So that's the final answer. You can find out these values in the calculator and you can substitute. So this is the material matrix B, straight displacement matrix B, which has been asked in the question. I'll take up the next question.